Hello children, how are you? In this video, we will learn exercise of the poem Noses from NCERT Medical Textbook Standard 4. Children, I have already explained this poem in both Hindi and English language. Also explain exercise in Hindi language. If you want to watch these videos, I give the link in the description box or you can search it in our channel's playlist. Okay children, let's see in the exercise. First topic is reading is fun. Here the question answers, we have questions and we have two answers according to this poem. First one, why does the poet feel that the nose is a funny thing? The answer is because it sticks out of the face like a handle shows out all of it and has two holes. Under it. Okay, children. Now see in next question. Why is your nose important for you? So answer is, the nose has two holes through which I breathe. The next question is, does the child in the poem like her nose? Why do you think so? So the answer is yes. The child likes her nose she considers it to be a funny thing. Now, next topic, let's talk. First one, describe a few funny things you have seen. Do they make you laugh? Children, the answer is, you should write also in this way, my pets fighting each other, dressing of some people, and face of my teddy bear. You can also write your own expressions and answers. Okay? Now next question is, what does features mean? Look up the dictionary. What are the different kinds of features of people we come across in the world? Children, here features are typical qualities or important parts of something. People with long flat nose, people with silky and curly hair. Children, you can also write your own answers here. This is just for activity. Next, let's sing. Children, this is also an activity and you do it yourself. Now, fun time. Sit in groups. Look at your friend's face and describe what you see. Use words like long, round, oval, slanted, sharp, flat to help you. You can use other words also. Children, here describing words, they can be colors, shapes, qualities, sizes, etc. Describing words means which adds the speciality in the subject or persons or things. So here I am explaining you some sentences used describing words about my friend. My friend has a long nose, she has a oval face. She has a small eyes. Children, you can write any other sentences about your own friend. This is for example only. Okay? Now next, what is your favorite fruit? Describe it in 5 sentences. Children, you can describe your own favorite fruit in 5 sentences. As an example, my favorite fruit is apple. So here are 5 sentences about it. My favorite fruit is an apple. Second line, it is very tasty. Third line, I eat an apple with its peel. Next line, it has small seeds. And last line, it is red in color. Okay, children. Children, here some questions based on our favorite fruit. We write here about apple. So here the answers should be on based on this fruit. So question first, how does it smell? It smells sweet. How does it look? It looks like a cricket ball. How does it feel? It is hard. Next question, when you bite it, what sound does it make? The answer is like tuck. Sound does it make? How does it taste? It tastes sweet. Okay, children. Now, next topic, let's exercise. A breathing exercise. Close your right nostril with your right thumb. Inhale slowly through your left nostril till your lungs are filled with air. Now, close your left nostril with your second and third fingers. Remove your finger from the right nostril and exhale through it. Repeat this exercise slowly in the beginning and with practice increase your speed. Children, here we have pranayama. And after completing this poem's exercise, you all have to do this pranayama. Before we go ahead, I want to explain to all of you about it. So, you all listen it carefully. This is Anulom Vilom Pranayam. Anulom Vilom Pranayam is one of the several pranayam or breathing exercise used in the practice of Hatha Yoga. It is very helpful in respiratory related like asthma. This pranayam is very helpful to the children because it makes the brain sharper. It helps also to cure mental problems like depression, anxiety and stress. So children, it is very useful and helpful to you. And every morning you have to do it. Okay? Okay children, now next topic, let's write. Do you know a fish breathes from its gills? Write two sentences about other animals which can breathe underwater. Children, now we have to write about other animals which can breathe underwater. I have some of them for you. Crocodile can breathe underwater. Snakes can also breathe under water. Punctuate the following passage. Mother, father, Neelam said, I have got a fire engine. I have got a fire engine. What's this? What's this? Called mother. Somewhat confused by the noise, I have got a fire engine. Mother, come and see it. Children, this exercise is punctuate. You have to punctuate this passage. Here the passage is given. What does mean by punctuation marks? Means you have to write with each punctuation marks and you have to start sentence with capital letter. You have to end sentence with full stop. You have to conversation. You have to put double quotes. Students, without punctuation, this passage is just a group of words but does not convey any proper thought. Now see, I put punctuation in it and you can understand meanings. So shall we start now? Okay. In inverted comma, mother, father, exclamation mark, inverted comma close, Neelam, Neelam's N is capital because it is noun, Neelam said, comma, inverted comma open, I have got a fire engine. comma, I have got a fire engine. Children, here I is in capital letter, okay? And have, VE, is also apostrophe. Now full stop and inverted comma close. Now next, what's this? Children, who said this? Yes, this line said by mother. So we put it in inverted comma. What's this? Question mark, inverted comma, close. Called mother. Full stop. Somewhat confused. Confused by the noise. Full stop. Inverted comma start. I in capital letter, apostrophe VE, got a fire engine, comma, mother, full stop, come and see it. Inverted comma close and full stop. Okay children, now the thought conveyed by this is the girl named Neelam. She called her parents. She is very excited and says them she got fire engine. I hope you all clear in your thoughts. Now next exercise, using a red pencil, choose and circle the things whose smell you like. Now with a blue pencil, circle the things whose smell you do not like. Make 5 sentences like this. I like or do not like the smell of blank because it reminds me of blank. Children, in this exercise, we underline with red pencil which things we like and underline with blue pencil which we don't like. So, look here. Children, first we underline the things which I like with red pencil. Okay? Rose. Scent, chocolate. In the second box, shampoo and champa. In the third box, soap, agarbatti, marigold. In the last box, coffee and elaichi. So children, these are my like things, okay? I like these things most. And now we underline with blue pencil, which I don't like. Petrol. In the second box, chips and rotten fruit. In the third box, dirty shoes. In the last box, paint and garbage. Okay children, is it clear now? Now children, some examples of sentences for you. First one, I like the smell of shampoo because It reminds me of chocolate. Now second, I like the smell of scent. Because it reminds me of rose. Now, in third line, I do not like the smell of dirty shoes. Because it reminds me of garbage. Now, in next line, I do not like the smell of paint as it reminds me of petrol. Last line, I like the smell of agarbatti. As it reminds me of Champa. Okay children, now in the next topic, let's sing. What is it? Children, here is a short poem. I will read it and you have to listen it carefully. And after, give me answer, which animal is describing in this poem. Okay, shall we start now? Tall ears, twinkly nose, tiny tail, and hope he goes. What is he? Can you guess? I feed him carrots and watercress. His ears are long. His tail is small and he doesn't make any noise at all. Tall ears, twinkly nose, tiny tail, and hope he goes. So children, which animal? Yes, is rabbit. Okay, now next, children, this short poem is written by Marie Louise Allen. Okay? Children, in next topic, write three pairs of words that rhyme with each other. Children, we have to write three pairs of words that rhyme based on this short poem. Then we find these types of rhyming words. Which are rhyming words? Yes. Nose, goes. Other rhyming words, gaze and watercress. Next, small and all. Okay, children. Children, if you have enjoyed this video, then like and share it. If you have already subscribed our channel, thank you so much for that. Still you haven't subscribed it, please subscribe it right now so that quickly you will get notification of our new videos. Your valuable suggestions are welcome in our comment box. Thanks for watching.